Hello everybody, I'm standing next to CFM56-5B and it belongs to this beautiful A320. And today I would like to tell you a little bit about this huge doors here on the side. We have same two on the other side and they are part of the thrust reverser system. What they are good for? Basically, when the aircraft land, pilots want to reduce the speed of the airplane. For that, they have brakes, but also they can use thrust reversers. How it works? When they will gonna activate them in a cockpit, these huge doors will gonna open and they'll gonna block the standard stream of the cold airflow and they're gonna revert it to the front. And this way, they will create a force which will slow down the airplane. But like every other mechanical equipment, also thrust reverser system can have a malfunction. And in that case, if we are not able to fix it, of course, we can deactivate thrust reversers. And we need to deactivate three different systems. If you want to deactivate thrust reverser, we need to deactivate them mechanically, we need to deactivate them electrically and hydraulically. For mechanical deactivation, we have here these slots for lockout pins. The pins are located under the fan cowl. We need to remove these covers, install the lockout pins, secure them on position. Each door need to be secured independently. We can take a look on the other side. We have point up there and one last one down here. Then we need to, as I said, deactivate hydraulically and electrically. For hydraulic deactivation, we need to deactivate HMU, which is also under the fan cowl, and electrically we need to deactivate it in the cockpit through MCDIU. When we fix the thrust reversers, we need to activate them, and this process I would like to show you, so let's take a look at it. As I mentioned before, each door is deactivated independently and the lock plate is red, so it is obvious for the pilots that the doors are blocked. Upon deactivation, you need to store lockout fairings on the position of locked pins, so when you need to activate the reverse system again, you have no problem to find them. And first thing to do is to remove them from the storage bracket. So let's start with the activation of the blocker doors. First thing is remove the screw which hold lock plate on position. Then we need to remove lockout bolt. And as you can see, it's really massive bolt. And I assume that you're wondering where the blocker doors are attached to. It is exactly here. And if you want to know how to deploy and stow blocker doors, click on the pop-up banner above, or lately after you watch this one, click on the link in the description below, which will lead you to a video which I already made about this topic. So take a look. And since lockout bolts are out, we can install lockout fairings. As a next step, we need to store the lockout bolts on storage bracket. And we need to do the same thing with the lock plate. And of course, I'm following the same procedure for all four blocker doors. This is all about mechanical reactivation. Now we move to hydraulical activation, which means activate hydraulic control unit. This is quite easy operation if you can squeeze your hand in this compartment. All what you need to do is to remove quick release pin that holds inhibition lever and move inhibition lever from the off position to the operational position. And after that, you just need to install the quick release pin in its operational position. This is all that had to be done on the engines. So now we can close the fan coils. Final check of the blocker doors, and we can move to the cockpit. Now all that's remaining is just to tell the airplane that reverser system is operational again by changing the status from inhibited to not inhibited. This step will also clear the message on the ECAM. And since FADEC have two independent channels, you need to be sure that both of them have the same status. Well, this is all about this topic. If you have any questions, please write them down in the comments. I'll be more than happy to answer to your questions. Don't forget to always use the latest AMM revision, because
this is the way.
This is the way. This is the way.
All what's remaining from my side is to say thank you for watching, guys. My name is Tomáš, this was Aircraft Maintenance with Zeto.r, and I will see you next one. Bye. You can see the writing on the-